Coming up on Sporting Dog Adventures, we kick off our high-flying action with the start of season 4. We head to central Louisiana to take Rommel on a teal hunt. It was fast-paced action with a few surprises along the way. Stay tuned for our season premiere coming up next on Sporting Dog Adventures.
Hey, pretty mama, go and grab the scattergun. Rommel's looking like he's got one more good run. His hips are a little shaky, but his heart's still true. Oh, how that dog loves hunting with me and you. Sporting Dog Adventures, run, boy, run. Everything you need is here under the sun. Everything you need is here under the sun.
Sporting Dog Adventures is brought to you by Cabela's, Heavy Shot, Hadel's Game Calls, Conquest Scent Sticks, Hi-Viz, Liberty Safe, Headwater Seat Covers, Mr. Lid, Mobile Strong, Pawprint Genetics, the Kansas Department of Wildlife, Parks, and Tourism, Vanishing Paradise, Pheasants Forever, and Soggy Acres Retrievers. Our hunt this week takes us to a central Louisiana rice field. We are hunting with Kelly Hadel, John and Austin Hebert, Minor Demang, and my good friend, Kevin Turner. Rommel was set up in the blind for his first hunt of the season. Our location looked really promising. We had birds buzzing all around us while we were setting up and well before legal shooting hours. It was really tough because all we had to do was wait until it's time to shoot. That was weird how they came in, man.
Yeah.
Here. Big group on the left. Group on the left, too. Big group. Look at that group. I was a little worried at first. We had birds working all around us, but something just wasn't quite right. Then, Mr. Miner made a minor adjustment, and wow, now we're on the X. He went and got the far ones for us, too.
Nice.
Here. Over. No. Over. Over. At this point, I thought Rommel had gone self-employed. We had several cast refusals, and then I realized the problem was mine. I was in a blind that was dark and he couldn't see my casts. So I called him in, got out of the blind, and I resent him, and then he performed like a champ. Where's the other one at? Drop. Heel. Over. We had a couple of birds down there made for some good blind retrieves. Rommel's doing a good job. A little excited this morning, but man, we are getting buzzed by birds, so I'm gonna jump back in the blind. Coming up on Sporting Dog Adventures, you'll get to find out what it's like to be buzzed by a group of teal. Our high-flying, rocket-fast teal action returns after this. This training tip is brought to you by Conquest Scent Sticks and these fine sponsors. On this week's training tip, we're going to teach you how to introduce a dog to decoys. I've got Lucy here. She's a very excited Labrador Retriever. She's a little bit older dog, but really never hunted waterfowl. The purpose of this exercise is to teach a dog how to run into and through decoys to retrieve down game. Step one, we're going to put a little bit of scent on the bumper. We're going to use Conquest Duck Scent from Conquest Scent Sticks. This helps scent it so that if the dog overruns it, doesn't see it fall, or gets preoccupied with the decoys, they can still use their nose to find it. We're then going to start about 10 yards away from our decoys. We're going to throw the bumper first into the decoys so that the dog can run in, retrieve it, bring it back. If the dog would for some reason hang up at this point, we're going to move right up to the edge of the decoys so that the dog actually has to take off from the decoys themselves. This will prevent them from hitting what would look like a brick wall, where they hit the decoys and go, wow, what is this? Once we have the dog retrieving in the decoys, we're going to make it a little more advanced. We're going to throw it through the decoys, maybe 10 to 15 yards past, so the dog actually has to go through the decoys and continue on with their momentum, find their down bird, or bumper in this case, and bring it back. Again, if the dog has trouble with this, you just simplify it and go back to step one and start with smaller increments. Always start things on land. You don't want to start with decoys in the water first because it's the hardest thing to fix. We're going to start on land so that we can move ourselves up and move our line up or where we're sending the dog from so that we can make her successful. Once we get through this exercise on the land, we'll show you the next step later in the season, which is going to water. That's this week's training tip. Now back to the hunt. Atta girl, good dog. We're back in the blind with birds working all around us. We had a group come out of nowhere and actually could hear them before we could see them. It's a unique sound and what I love about teal hunting. Now sit back, turn up the volume on your TV, and listen to these little fighter jets buzz the tower. Low on the deck. How many did we put down that time? Something 5-6. Ah. Here. Come on, buddy. Yeah, we're speed retrieving before we get more birds in. Ah. It was a great pleasure watching and learning how to call teal from Kelly Hadle and the Aber Boys. Young Austin was phenomenal and could call in just about anything. Bust him. Bust him. Sit. 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 Matt, you think he'd fetch it?
Maybe.
Back.
We can put that in the gumbo pot too.
Come on, fetch it up. Bring it here. Let's go. He'll fetch anything for me. Rommel fetched a crow.
Big flock to your left. Big flock to your left.
Big flock.
Cut him up, boys.
Nice shot. Here. Oh, there's one. That's the other That's cool stuff. I love watching dogs do that. Here. Two more. We got nine. We had some birds sail pretty far on us. So we took Rommel out of the blind, down the levee a couple hundred yards, and set him up for a great blind retrieve. Ah! He's a nice dog. That was about a, probably a 250 yard water blind right there. Pretty cool. We're about halfway to our limit. We've got about, I think 18, 19 birds now, and we can, we've got a few to go. Looks like we're gonna hit it too, so we better get back to the blind. Hope you guys are enjoying this part of the show. Stay tuned for more high flying adventures after this. This segment of Sporting Dog Adventures is brought to you by these fine sponsors.
And now it's time for this week's Kids Corner.
Hey, welcome to this week's Kids Corner. I'm here with Austin. We're in Louisiana. Austin, you're on Hadel's pro staff. You're a very accomplished caller. I want to know more about that and how you got into it.
I just grew up around duck hunters and duck calling. I mean, it was in my blood before I knew what I was doing. I was growing up with a duck call in my mouth, pretty much. And met Mr. Kelly and Mr. Rod and became good friends.
And now, you're being a little bit modest. You're saying that you competed. You've actually won how many titles? Seven state champion?
Seven-time Louisiana state championships. And I've won a couple of years in Speckleback calling, too.
Now, Austin, you got everybody else in your school. I imagine they're playing football, baseball. You got a little bit different sport you compete in as well at school.
We have a skeet team, actually. My dad's the coach, and our team won Paris last year, and about half of them went to state. You have to be in the top 30 from our southern regionals to go to state, and about half of our team went. So we were really excited and had a lot of fun.
Awesome. It shows in your shooting, too. We've been putting some birds on the water today, that's for sure.
Yeah. We did really good, man. Killing 12 out of a flock.
Yeah.
That's something to be proud of right there.
Yeah. Hope you guys enjoyed this week's Kids Corner. Now let's get back to the hunt. Nice shot on that one. I saw you hit that one. Did that one get away? Oh. Here.
Over.
Come on, boy. Good boy. That's a good retrieve he got. Hunt's going really well. I'd say probably one more group, and we're going to have our limits all set. Rommel's running well. He did a hell of a retrieve. We're going to give him some Scooby snacks after. So I hope you guys are enjoying it. It's back to the blind time.
Yeah, retrieve farming balls.
Hunting different parts of the country gives me an opportunity to learn about the area's history and flavor. One thing seems constant though, love of friends, family, and the game we pursue.
We are people that stay together. We work hard, we play hard,
We have a love of family, a love of God, and a love of fun, and that's what we do. I mean, it's proven all over South Louisiana what we do. You look at the fairs and the festivals and the music
Absolutely.
That we have here. It's all about family and fun.
And now it's time for this week's Conservation Corner, presented by Vanishing Paradise.
The Mississippi River Delta and the warm coastal marshes around Louisiana support some of the best hunting and fishing in the world. In fact, Louisiana is known as sportsman's paradise. Unfortunately, these wetlands are suffering from one of the highest rates of land loss on the planet. Every hour, a football field of land disappears from the coast of Louisiana. Learn more about why this is happening and how we can reconnect the river with its wetlands and rebuild the Delta's marshes, wetlands, cypress forests, and barrier islands to save this vanishing paradise. Find out how you can help at vanishingparadise.org.
Coming up on Sporting Dog Adventures, we wrap up our hunt in perfect Cajun-style fashion.
Be sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter for your chance to win a puppy from Soggy Acres Retrievers and other great prizes from our sponsors.
Sporting Dog Adventures is brought to you by Cabela's, Heavy Shot, Hadel's Game Calls, Conquest Scent Sticks, Hi-Viz, Liberty Safe, Headwater Seat Covers, Mr. Lid, Mobile Strong, Paw Print Genetics, the Kansas Department of Wildlife, Parks and Tourism, Vanishing Paradise, Pheasants Forever, and Soggy Acres Retrievers. This product review is brought to you by The Outdoor Hub. Most people know the Liberty Safe name, but I want to tell you about this brand and the quality of its product. This is the number one gun safe on the market. You have a safe that is affordable, American made, and you can custom design inside for all of your needs. Every Liberty Safe has a lifetime warranty, quality manufacturing, and a superior locking mechanism that makes it stand above and beyond all the other models. These safes come in different sizes. I personally have the 41 gun safe. It holds 41 firearms for me, as well as a custom on-door pocket system where I can put different things from items that need to stay cooler to my clips to my handguns. It's thermostatically controlled, and with their new safe alert system, we actually have it set up so that if someone would open the safe and they're not authorized, I'll actually get a call on my phone. Liberty Safe. If you're looking for a quality safe to protect your valuables as well as your firearms, go to libertysafe.com and pick out your model today. So our hunt's not complete because we haven't eaten. Now, you got us a true Cajun breakfast.
We did, duck blind breakfast. We have boudin, we'll have Evangeline made bread, and we have Steen's cane syrup.
Nice.
And that's, boudin is a Cajun staple. It's basically rice dressing stuffed in a sausage casing. And it's got everything you need. It's got the carbs, it's got the protein, it's got everything. So
and the spices.
And the spices.
Nice. I'm excited. This will be good.
That's awesome.
The breakfast of champions.
Now we get to keep eating till we're full, and then we invite the rest of the guys back in.
That's right.
The Southern hospitality, great calling and hunting, and overall experience with our new friends in Louisiana made this a hunt to remember.
Now this right here is a fig cake. And this would put Fig Newtons out of business if they ever found out about it. We try to keep this a secret down here in Louisiana.
That's right. It's heaven.
When the morning flight finally ended, the rice field was still teeming with action from all the diverse wildlife.
We've had some really good seasons in the past. It's been a little dry this year, so if you have water, you have a few birds. We'd like to see more water around us, so you're holding birds, you know, because once you shoot them up, you got to let them rest. But pretty typical for South Louisiana this time of year. It's more about the kids and the camaraderie. The Cajun breakfast, coming out and enjoying it. just enjoying Mother Nature and enjoying the wildlife. And if you shoot a limit, great.
Well, guys, we had a great hunt, 32 birds down. I'm pretty proud of us that we got 12 in one volley, too.
Yeah, that was
great. Rommel did a nice job. He's taking a drink for himself here while he relaxes. Really appreciate you guys having us out. Kelly, thanks for helping set this up for us.
Absolutely.
If you guys want a great hunt, come to Louisiana for a teal hunt. 32 birds in about 2 hours. Hope you guys enjoy this week's show. Stay tuned for next week's High Flying Adventures. Next week on Sporting Dog Adventures, we head to South Dakota for an action-packed pheasant hunt. I take my boys, my father, and the dogs of Soggy Acres Retrievers as we hit the field chasing wild roosters. Closed captioning provided by Hadel's Game Calls.
Are you looking for a puppy? Chocolate black or yellow?
Contact Soggy Acres Retrievers at soggyacres.com.
Y'all gonna have a delicacy. Y'all gonna have a real Cajun breakfast in the duck blind.
Is that right?
Boudin sandwiches. I couldn't bring the Budweiser, but I mean Boudin sandwiches.
Everything you need is here under the sun.